Hey, what's going on, guys? Drone B here, and we've got another new building out. They're throwing these buildings at us like crazy. This is the Crystal Nexus, and I had a bunch of people from older realms message me about this a couple weeks ago, like saying, hey, what is this Crystal Nexus? And I had no idea, but I now know. I got it. I unlocked it. And here it is, guys. It's this little blue building down by your wall, by your entrance, the Crystal Nexus. And what it is you get access to temporary boosts. So if we come over here and we see there's this icon here, you can click it, and these are all different boosts you can get. Right now there's, 12 different boosts. We've got this one, which is kind of cool. The pack came with this one. It allows you to, it upgrades all your quests to at least the green or better. What is that, uncommon? Yeah, uncommon or better. So that's kind of a cool thing. It lasts for 30 seconds. So basically it'll convert them all over to green, and then you have to wait just over a day and 6 hours before you can use this one again. And then there's all these different ones. There's some pretty good ones, guys. Mark size 500, you know, that's kind of small. There's this one, research speed 50%. Now that could be pretty useful depending on where you're at. There's this one, construction speed, all the way up to divine. We've got this one, tiger's eye, which is a hero attack, so for hitting monsters. We've got a quick stone, which is march speed. That one lasts an hour, so that'd be really good for like Magitek events and neutral realm events. Now here's the one, guys. We need to get this one. It's diamond steel core. City defense HP 1500%, city defense armor bonus 1500, and it lasts for 12 hours. So this would be like an awesome one for RVRs or realm events. You know, if you're getting attacked a lot, this would be really cool to have. There's this one, which is training speed, significant training speed. So if you just hit T6, you just hit T7, activate this one. That would be pretty awesome. We've got Fire Fury Core. A city assault attack bonus 3000% for 2 hours. Dang. Unconquerable hero, so your hero can't be captured for 20 minutes. That would be nice if you want to attack somebody that you probably shouldn't be attacking. We've got city defense attack bonus, so this is a good one for trap accounts. I wish I had this one the other day, that would be nice. And glacial core, so mage attack and mage armor, and crazy mage armor. So, pretty cool, guys. Now, you're probably wondering, okay, Brett, so you've got this building, you get the unlock, you get it unlocked. Now, how do you get the materials? Because right here it says go to gold store. And, you know, hopefully you don't have to go to the gold store to get all these, right? Now, I did see in the events, they drop, at least for a little bit, they've been dropping these, here they are, these crystal core fragment chests. So you get these crystal core fragment chests. At least for now, they're in the events. You know, this is the kind of thing, there's no guarantee they're always going to be there. They might be there for a long time. They might disappear next week. So what I would say, guys, is do as many of these events as you can while they're there. They even are in the Adventurer's Day quests, which is cool. Because normally you don't get anything special in these. So I would do all the Adventurer's Day quests you can do. Anything you can do without, you know, extending yourself too far in gold department. Stock up on those, guys. And what you do with those, you open them in the items, and then there's a new category in the Magitek Converter. We've got Crystal Core section. And so you open up those chests, and it'll give you fragments. And then you, once you get enough fragment, you can then create a core. So like this one, you need 1,000. And 1,000, you know, I actually have no idea how many chests that'll take. I've probably opened... Oh, I could be way off, guys. I could be way off. Maybe I've opened 100 chests, maybe only 50, maybe 20. I don't know, but yeah, I have no idea. So imagine it's a lot though, right? So the ones that we want, we really want the diamond steel core, and I've only got 73 out of 1,000. So, you know, it's going to be slow getting these boosts, but when you get enough saved up for a boost, it's an awesome boost. So what I would say, guys, and this seems to be the recommendations I give for all the buildings, but I wouldn't unlock the Nexus Core unless you get a ton of these fragments stored up. Now there's, I'm trying to remember, I'm worried giving that advice if the cores aren't, I'm wondering, so here's a good question, guys. If somebody knows this, it'd be cool if you leave a comment, whether you see it or not, but that's not the one we want. It'd be cool if you leave a comment and let me know if you don't have the Nexus core unlocked, are you seeing the Fragment chests in the quests? Because if you are and you don't have to unlock it to get these core chests, I would just stock up on the core chests. Get as many of these Crystal Core Fragment chests as you can. And I would wait until you get so much saved up that you can use these boosts for a while. And I recommend doing the same thing for the Oracle Temple. You know, get the Oracle Dust, get the materials for that before you unlock it. Because, you know, there's no rush to unlock it, basically. If you can't, you know, be crafting a bunch of these. So, but, I mean, these are really good boosts, guys. So if you can get enough of those cores saved up, something to think about. 15 and 15, 3,000. Those are pretty solid. And even this one, you know, you can get a lot of guild loyalty points. You can get, you know, better items. You get, you know, food, gold, hero XP, all that stuff. You know, kind of interesting. It's definitely a unique building. Now, another thing I would say to you guys is make sure that it comes with the Magitek Converter, or make sure you already have the Magitek Converter, because you're not going to be able to craft the cores without the Magitek Converter. So, yeah, that's sort of the fine print. My guess is that this building will come with the Magitek Converter if you don't have both of them. Hopefully that's the case. Hopefully, maybe you already have the Magitek Converter, but whatever you do, don't unlock the Nexus if it doesn't come with or you don't have the Magitek Converter. That seems to be pretty vital, because you're not going to... This building's completely useless without the cores. And you need that converter to get the cores. So I'm rambling on here a little bit, guys. What I'm going to do, I think that pretty much covers the Magitek Converter. You know, again, it's another one of those buildings. Save up your chests. Once you get enough chests, then maybe it's worth unlocking. Yeah, that pretty much sums it up. And now what I'm going to do, guys, is I got attacked by a Citadel 66. So it was like a 400-something K mark size. So I recorded it. I'm going to share it with you guys, maybe throw some music on with it. It's kind of fun because I also have my trap account open. So you can see my trap account attacked a few times. And then all of a sudden you see me panic and try to defend my account right here, guys. And I fail miserably. I get owned so bad. And looking back at it, and you guys can observe this for yourselves, you can see how I was trying to deal with this in real time. And I made some pretty big mistakes. The first thing I did is, I kind of figured I wouldn't be attacked. And that was a pretty big mistake to make. The second thing I did is I actually was really lacking on my troops. I had like almost no troops, guys, because I was slowly dismissing them. Because I was getting ready to make, I was making room for T3. Yeah, guys, I'm going to build a ton of T3. I was making room for T6 because I have some T6 unlocked now. And at the time, I was really close. So I was making room for the T6. So I hadn't been retraining troops. So I was low troop count. The next mistake I made, luckily I had my hero gear on. But, you know, I had decent gear on. But I had it on Ignis. So I couldn't switch to my Luna because my Luna had monster gear. Actually, all my other heroes had monster gear, so I was stuck with Ignis, and Ignis is okay, but it would have been nicer to have my Luna. My hospital size would have been a lot bigger, and my defense, I would have had more defensive, more HP, more armor, that kind of thing. And then another mistake I made is I didn't have any of these activated. I just activated this one, but it would have been nice to have some of the, you know, some of the armor, some of the HP. Would have helped a little bit. And then another, I made so many mistakes. I just wasn't ready for it, guys. I was not ready. I wasn't thinking anybody would attack me. But I had all my best commanders on my troop eater, so on my trap account. So all my good stuff was in troop eater. What else did I do wrong? Oh, probably the biggest mistake I made. I would have been okay, except for I made this fundamental mistake of having almost no food. And what I'm going to recommend, guys, and I think this is, you know, this is just a good general rule of thumb. I probably should have taken my own advice on this because I'm sure I've mentioned this before, but always have like billions of food activated and opened. So, you know, it might take a half hour to just sit here and keep buying food. But I would recommend, as long as you're not draining your food, so assuming you don't have T1 or T2 or, you know, mercenary troops that are going to eat your food away, I would open up like billions because then you can heal up your troops when you're attacked. And I made the crucial mistake of healing up only part of my troops. And it heals your guardians, right? So I healed my guardians, my good guardians, my golden, legendary, awesome, badass guardians. I healed them up, but the problem is I still had half my hospital capacity filled up. And then I got attacked again, and it killed off all my golden guardians. Like 60,000 just thrown to the wasteland. And it was all because I didn't have enough food. I would have been completely fine. My hospital would have refilled up, but I would have been completely fine had I had a billion more food open up. So that was totally my mistake. I deserve to lose my guardians there. But yeah, here it is, guys. I'm going to throw that up now, and I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm going to make another video here in a little bit, too, so check back in a little bit, and...
Yeah.